So, I've created this populated factory and successfully removed some complication from the actual .jdbc connector code. But there is still one problem here, is that the column info idea came from the original feature discovery part, where I just saw the columns that come from the database. But when I use the column info in a Dust environment, I need the separation between the attribute and the link definitions, because for a database that is exactly the same, it's just the column, but for Dust I have to handle it differently. Right now the column info and the related codes are a bit too complicated because of this. They do not reflect the actual usage. So what I have to do now is to refactor this thing, keep the column info as an abstract class, and separate the attribute definitions and the link definitions. I have already started this process by splitting the populated factories of attributes and references. So now I should finish the job by saying that the column info is abstract, and derive an attribute and the column info and ref info, column info, and see how it goes. Column name, the entity, column data, that stays the primary key. I guess primary key can be a reference. Okay, I don't want to decide it for now. So the foreign table info goes out to the ref info. Type goes info. Of column info, and the column is ref, so that would be a duplication because it's derived. So this part of the constructor goes down to the individual derived classes. And the at info and the ref info, I will do the same. So I call the super, so I don't need this part, and I am with the at info. So this attribute parent part stays here. What was the EDB type? Was that? Type info. Make it simple, so now we just refactor, so now I don't actually think about I should, because I don't want to repeat this part here. What I want to do, because both constructors need this information, then the EDB type should go out as a member to the parent. Let's say it's a final. And the constructor, super's constructor, initializes the EDB type, so I can use it in the derived classes constructor. So yes, this is the part that I should do in an at info. Now for ref info, I basically do the same, but execute the ref part. See if there's any problem with that. Nothing. So well, it looks fine. Therefore, EDB type is not initialized. That's not really nice. PF type info. Hmm. trim to temp. I rename it to temp because I plan to change this whole thing again. So for now, I just accept this. Okay, so I do not need this ref anymore. Okay. Access entity, get entity, link def, add def. Okay, so I remove this from here. Doesn't help. So then it will not be final. And I will handle it, of course, in the derived classes. So now in the @info, I create an @def, and in the ref info, it's not good because I use the e column here. Okay, that leads me no. Okay, forget. This means I want to create a final column, but I would need a function call. Can I do this? I can. So the e column is final, and the fact that it's a reference comes from the actual class, which says yes, I am. Or even simpler, I would need it in the super constructor. Okay. I don't need the function as well. That should be protected, of course. And it's also protected. Almost. Okay. And in this way, and for references, it's true. Okay, the opt set at type goes, of course, down to the at info, where it has it, where it makes sense, and init key data. The isref. Of course, I will not need that. And it's not needed either there, but no, they will be separated by their containers, so that's not a big deal. The init key data. Should be quite done. Nobody wants to play with that any more. What was that? It's void. I remove everything. Good. And key data pk info colon I still think that if I use a record to connect two tables, the primary key constraint can be created a composite primary key with two references. Okay, anyway. This is what you do. Here. And this is where you just super init key data PI. And what I need here is this thing. And let's say that it has also a key data. Say that the ref info will have a ref data. Ref data and the ref data So this way I have a column info. Of course, I need this other constructor as well. And so I have hopefully successfully split the column to addInfo and refInfo. And what I have here is that the pf adds is of addInfo type. This is info, and of course the constructor is the same way. Great. I populate these factories. And now the question is how I use it. So I have this get call info function here. Okay. Is the isref used at all? It's more likely to be an attribute, so I try to get it from CI. So the column info is okay here. Register column. Okay, let's see if I need it down here. Well, well, well. Let's say that I create an init for select function map. Prepare for selects. Map links. The same thing down here. The prepare for select will be this. Object type. While here, this is. And what kind of map is this? Sorry. Looks fine. Okay. This call that is not used anymore, as I see. All right, and
this is what I have to do inside the call info. So actually run the cycle like set. No, it's load. Load value. And I will need this. Or maybe not. Try without it. Can I extract it to a function? Okay. Do it. Hello. Load value in column info, column of course that will be abstract. The load value with this code. And that's info. Yes, I need the target entity as a parameter. And I need the same thing here. With different content. And ref info load value. Let's do it ugly. Because this is how we like it. So this is executing the select itself, or I mean loading the data from the select. It's so funny. Okay, metadata, column info, collect is prepared for select, and the map links, and if it's a primary key, then I will use it. Well, that's nice. And this is the point where I have this register column. If it's used only once, and I always hide it, then I don't create a get function for it. So theoretically, I have split the column info to at info and ref info, separated the functionalities and cleaned the code a bit, because at this point there's one thing, the table info does the split between the pfrefs and the pfats when I call the register column and also the get column info. I'm afraid I should move this down here. Because this way they are so nicely packed together. Okay, I have my attributes. Okay. Yeah, this map at is something that I I may move this functionality to, well, to the development. That would be a nice thing, because during the development I will need this many times. The question is, the dustutils dev is somewhere outside, isn't it? Well, let's see. You are with the Java. That's something that I can't use. How about test utils? Or temp hex? That's a good place, I guess. So what I want here is that
I want to have a map of string to objects. Past entity from and I send this as a parameter to and checked what are the types. Okay, if attributes, then I create it. Otherwise, I clear it if null is the types. Types is null, then types equals new object array of one. This as for resolve for sure, so you can use keys here, and then you do the same thing as you did in the JDBC connector here. Where that's
That is types E. Oh, but I don't have to use this thing here. Doesn't, it's not necessary. How about that? That's nice. So I don't have an else. As part here. Okay, then it should be, as you say, effectively final. And the only thing is that I'm not getting this from the self, but from the entity, but of course then on front, and so you can use an object here. Oh, it's also an entity that I don't need that. Nice. So it's just from. Very good, and let's say that the map parameter is always necessary. But the from may be, sorry, no. And the only thing is that if I have not passed any type, then the target type should be value. Of the primary type. So that's fine, and I can use this function here. I only need needed the my is my type for this function call. That would be very nice. So what? Oh, sorry, that's my public static function. Load ads. Ads. From is the self. And I can use the attributes. But no, but it's still okay. So I need some nice little touch here. And let's see if we still work after this nice refactor. Should we cause problem with the init? Okay, update params. Well,
Okay. So see what happens here. What is your problem? I have the self. I have a map ads which is empty. Ugly. I clear it. The types is M. Sorry. Return. Of course, now I have to restart, but does not really matter. I haven't seen DB close. Well, anyway, no, because this attribute collection is executed before creating the connection, so that's fine. Okay, so again, let's send the init. Oops, failed. Hello, good. So, load the attributes. Clear. Just remained here. So then I have created a new array, and yes, it will collect the attributes from the JDBC connector type, which is now filled with the required content automatically. Okay, let it go. And it succeeded. DB connection closed. Sorry. Should check this later. Another init. Does no harm, but the DB connection closed is here again. From where does it come? Oh my god. There is an exception here. Okay. That was ugly. Okay, very nice. The products from the refactors. That's ref data, of course. Great. So again. Now that's weird. Okay, let's enable the null pointer exception and show me again. So you say that the foreign table info is null, which is, of course, a bad idea. Okay, I am afraid this init key data should have been called from constructor. Oh yes, exactly, that's what I have forgotten. Even before doing anything, I called the init key data, and this is something I need here too. Okay, so we have survived the initialization. Let's see if we have the types. We do. Do we have the link defs and call defs? We do. Okay, so start from the beginning without the corrected exceptions. So let's load the database command, send the init message.
send the process message. And it did not work. No, sorry, I was loading the stuff. Excuse me. I was loading the stuff and the stuff is okay. Nice. Just for fun, send it again. I don't know what happens with this picture thing. Somehow it's always different. All the others are fine. Oh, sorry, that's an object. And I get the actual object instance to string, which is now something. Well, that looks fine. So I have actually survived this refactor where I just split the @info and the refinfo, moved all the functionality to the related classes. It should be in the update params, it should be in the of create con. Release con. Active init. Release. And the process. Nice. So finally, what we have here, we are able to use a JDBC connector, a generic JDBC connector, to connect to any database, learn the type info set that the database has, like varchar and these kind of things. We are able to load all the type definitions, that means the tables, from the database. We detect primary keys, foreign keys, and attribute types. And we can translate the remote types and remote values to local values that Dust can handle. And we can load data from the database. We also worked a bit on refactoring the actual JDBC connector class so that we have a clear functionality what we have to do in order to execute a select and process the results, initialize and collect the meta information from the database, We are doing safe connection closing. We keep the connection instance open, but we are prepared to having it closed by the remote server. We can just reconnect to it. And most of the code is obviously connect the remote library provided language like result set and metadata and these kind of things into local objects and Dust entities. However, this is a bad solution. Bad because the JDBC connector contains data. So this class is not only executing logic, but also contains collected information from the database and from from the Dust model layer, which is a problem because in this way the connector and its contained data is hidden from Dust and can go out of sync. So my next task is to actually design the structure of this JDBC connection unit and completely refactor the whole code again. The aim is that the JDBC connector should only contain algorithms that transfer knowledge from the database to knowledge in the Dust model layer and should not store this information, which would lead to synchronization problems. We have created these factories, and these factories are in fact usable or useful, but should only exist as long as a procedure is running. So when the connector is initializing, it should contain or can contain a populated factory for all the information that it needs. But when the initialization function returns, it should not have anything anymore. Actually, it should be stateless, so to say. So that will be the next task.